Greetings from me and my team at Silverline Hospital. We are here to discuss the importance of exercise in diabetes management. Exercise and a proper diet can be far more effective than the best medicines or insulins that we have. So that's how important exercise and diet is to diabetes management. And therefore, we thought we should bring out this edition of a video describing in detail how a diabetic patient can exercise and what are those exercises that can be safely done by a diabetic.
Stretching exercises. Neck stretching. Keep your right elbow behind you. Place the left hand on top of your head and hold at right ear level. Slowly tilt your head towards the left and apply gentle pressure with your left hand. You will feel a nice stretch. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Shoulder stretching. Place the right hand on the opposite shoulder and grab elbow with your left hand and press towards the left side. You can feel a nice stretch on the shoulder. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Forearm stretch. Use your left palm to pull the fingers of your right palm until the stretch begins in the right forearm. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Side stretching. Bend your right elbow over the head and hold the elbow with the left hand. Gently pull the right elbow towards left side. You will feel a nice stretch in your right torso. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Standing quadriceps stretch. Stand straight with proper support and bend your right knee. Use the right hand to pull your right foot towards your butt. You will feel a nice stretch on the front of your thigh. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Hamstring stretch. Keep the heel of your right foot up on a surface that is lower than your hip, such as a chair or bench, and bend forward towards your right leg. You will feel a nice stretch on the back of your thighs. Hold that position. Do the same to the opposite side. Progressive resistance exercises. Shoulder rotations. Place both your hands on the shoulders. Roll the shoulders forward and backward. Elbow pump. Keep your shoulders in 90 degree position and bend your elbow in and out. Start 5 to 10 repetitions without weight. As you progress, add a half liter bottle on both hands and repeat the same exercise. Upward elbow pumping. Raise your arms and keep the arms close to your head with the elbows bent perpendicular to the floor. Do extension and flexing of your elbow, progressively increasing the repetition and adding weights on each hand. Wrist pumping. Clench your fists loosely and move your wrists upward and downward. Start with 10 to 15 repetitions without weight and progressively increase repetitions. Hold half liter bottle or equivalent weight in each hand and repeat the exercise. Alternate hand raise. Keep your elbows straight and alternatively raise your arms upward and downward. As you progress, increase repetition by holding a half liter bottle or equivalent weight on each hand and repeat the exercise. Sideways arms lifting. Raise both your arms sideways overhead. As you progress, add weights on each hand. Arms full rotation. Keep your arms straight and do circles in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. As you progress, you can add weights. Standing hip flexion. Keep your back straight. Lift your knee towards the tummy and do it alternatively. Half squat. Keep your feet slightly more than shoulder width apart. Keep your back in neutral position. With or without arm support, slowly bend your knees until it is in 90 degree angle. Slowly return to the starting position. Standing calf raise. Stand in front of a chair or wall for support. While maintaining balance, raise your body on your toes and lower your ankle down slowly. Breathing exercise. Take a deep breath through your nose while raising your arms upwards. Then extend your arms backward with force while expelling the air. Tummy exercises. Single leg and head raise. Lie down on your back and lift your right leg 40 to 60 degrees while slightly lifting your upper body. Hold the position for 5 seconds and then relax by going back to starting position. Do the same on the opposite side. Both legs and head together. Lie down on your back and lift both legs together at around 45 degrees along with upper back and head. Keep both hands firmly on the ground on the side. Hold the position for 5 seconds and then relax by going back to starting position. Abdominal reverse curl. Lie down on your back and bend your knees together to bring it towards your chest. Then move it back to starting position. Repeat the same continuously. Aerobic exercise. Aerobic exercises in the form of treadmill walks, cycling, swimming, or brisk walk is advised. At least 20 to 25 minutes of aerobic exercise must be done along with the above exercises.
Hi, this is Vaipo. I'm the chief physiotherapist at Silverline Hospital. Nowadays, we know exercise is very important for health, and it is more important if you have diabetes. Pre-exercise assessment is very important, especially if you have diabetic complications like diabetic neuropathy, retinopathy, or if you have any kind of musculoskeletal impairments. So you should see a diabetologist or physiotherapist just prior to start your exercise. They can plan and execute according to your health status. So in our specific exercise protocol, we formulate the combination of aerobic and anaerobic kind of exercise that include stretching, strengthening, tummy, breathing and aerobic form of exercise. So this is very simple and universal exercise any age populations can do. Please follow the diabetic exercise properly and stay healthy.